What's up, guys, and welcome back to House Flipper 2. If you're enjoying this series, make sure you leave a like on the video. It'd be greatly appreciated. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, after the previous episode, I was kind of thinking that that was it. Like, surely there's nothing more that we can do here. But as it turns out, we have one final job. I say final with a question mark because honestly, I don't even know anymore. But this one comes to us from our very own parents. It says, "Hi, sweetie. Yes, you read the email subject right." Oh, I didn't read that. "We're moving back to Pinnacove! Sunset Bay reminded me so much of our lovely town that it made me homesick, even if technically I was home all the time. But don't worry, our old house is still yours. That's good. I really liked living on the seashore, so we decided to find something on the coast. Tom helped us buy a lovely house, only the interior is too pastel for my liking. And since you're a big-time house renovator now, I thought you could prepare the place for us. We've sent some of our stuff in advance, and in terms of the walls and furniture, I trust you know what colors and styles I like. I have no idea. I haven't the slightest clue. I hate to break it to you, Mom. And there's a room for you too if you ever wanted to stay over. Love you, Mom." Let's start the job. From the little thumbnail, it looks smallish, but very cute. Very quaint. Got a nice, like, patio, porch area over here. Wraparound porch? Almost. It's a pretty good size one, though. I'm not gonna do anything weird here. Thankfully, there's no garage that I can enter in through. We're just gonna go straight through the front door, like a normal person would. Usually I don't do that, though. You guys know the deal. We're, very unorthodox here. All right, I kind of do like the super raised ceiling and sort of this lofted area here. Looks nice. Looks very nice. Let's just make our rounds and we'll try to find some light switches. Get those kicked on so we can at least see what we're doing in these rooms. Okay, pretty decent bathroom as well. Back in here. Oh, that's an exterior door. Okay. That's the little porch patio area. Got another ceiling tite in there. And then back in here must be like a closet or something. I'm sure we'll figure it out. But yeah, it is completely, by the looks of things, completely unfurnished. But a very, very cool area up here. I don't know what it is, but I just love this, dude. I love a lofted section in a house. I know it's not very practical. I just think it looks really nice. And then this is most certainly a closet. Some sort of storage area. Okay, there is another light here. Nice. All right. Yeah, Mom and Dad. Oh, okay. Can't get through there. Mom and Dad, they picked a good one. They have certainly picked a good one here. So, where do we begin? Perhaps on this patio thing? Get this out of the way real quick. They need an umbrella, two little lounge chairs, and a table. Like an end table. That end table does look very out of place, but like where else do I put it? I could put it closer to one chair than the other, and then it looks even more out of place. I think I'm just gonna leave it here. That'll work. That'll have to do. And this is also the only way that I can place down the umbrella. If I try to put the base over here, it's actually too long. Notice how much it's sticking out, like how much further past the railing it sticks out. So that's probably the only spot for it as well. Wait, can we? No, we can't pull it down. Dang, missed opportunity again. But that looks nice. Not my first pick for color there. But that's what Mom and Dad wanted, apparently. Okay, next room is gonna be a bedroom, I believe, but there's also an office chair, which is confusing, because there's no desk. Maybe we're gonna, wait, does this float? Can you mount it on the wall? Potentially? It happened there for a second? Oh no, that's not how it works. Okay, you know what? We'll figure it out. Not a big deal. I do think that the bed for sure has to go right underneath that window. That should... Oh, yeah, and look at the outlets are, like, perfectly placed already. Okay, this is great. This is... Surely, this is exactly what they're after. And I would know, as their son, right? Oh, there is, too, a desk. What the heck? I definitely did not see that when we were first flipping through. I suppose it was always there, though. It was always there all along. What are these patterns? Dude, what is going on here? All right, after we finish this job for mom and dad, we have to have like a serious sit-down discussion with them and their decorating abilities. This ain't it. I'm also very confused as to where they would like us to place this sixth plant when there are only five plant pots. Wait, I've got it. There's gotta be something in here. Okay, well that's definitely not it. Let's just put everything on the desk for now. Lots of postcards. Does this count as a planter? Maybe. Let's hope that there's something else in here. Maybe this? Lots of purple, though. That must be mom's favorite color. I mean, of course that's mom's favorite color. I would know. I'm their son. I'm gonna get these placed in there, I think. There's not really a good spot to display those. Also, I'm not really sure what they're for. But now, nice. We're gonna find out if we can place these up on the corkboard. That's what they would have wanted. On to the next room, then. Hopefully less purple this time around. We shall see. I am for sure gonna have to place that there because it wouldn't work over here with that window. And then like a little ottoman thing, we can plop that sucker down right there. Easy. Too easy, in fact. Wait, is there more? There's more. Why does it always show me the buy option first, dude? I don't get it. It's always like, oh, just buy all this stuff and then paint around it. Like, that doesn't make any sense. But they're getting the parakeet wallpaper. You bet your sweet bippy, as you can see right here. They love it. They're crazy about it. Honestly, what were they thinking? I mean, if you really love parakeets, this is certainly the wallpaper for you. Also, what was interesting is I'm fairly certain they had me paint this wall, even though they were gonna have us wallpaper over top of it later. Moving right along then into the bathroom. We just have to unbox their stuff for them. Sure. Yeah, we can help them with that. Got a soap dispenser right here, I think. Let's put that down there. A glass. Just a cup. Sure. That works. This is definitely a toilet brush, but a decorative one at that. I'm into it. Let's put it right over there. Sure, they're going to have some TP, right? I've said surely too many times already this episode, so I'm trying not to say it. Let's put the candles back here, though. I think that's going to look the best. They'll probably be burning candles while taking a little bubble bath or something. Not sure if shampoo or body wash, but it's definitely called Young Spice. It's vegan though, it's vegan friendly, so that's good. Last but not least, a trash can. Oh, let's fix that shadow really quick. There we go. All right, done deal. Wait, the sconces. Oh, they have their own separate switch that I completely missed. The sconces are now on. No toilet paper, really? Okay, I gotta do it. Just one roll to help them out, you know, until they go to the store and start stocking up on stuff. That way, if they need to go during that time, it's ready for them. Ready to be used. Okay, let's close that door on up. Why did the exclamation pop back up? Is there more? There's always more! There's always something else, isn't there? Okay, where is this going to go? Let's get out our tiling tool. Oh, okay. Do we have to tile behind the mirror? I'm gonna move it just to make sure. Let's just put it up there a little bit higher. Temporarily, we do not. But I'm glad I checked. Couple more right here. Dunzo. Finished. Let's get that mirror moved back down then. And we can sell off all the extra. Okay, now the bathroom is actually finished. I do like how this is like diagonal. Is that the word I'm looking for? Rather than, well, no, these are diagonal as well. Rather than it being square like this backsplash. How about the kitchen next? That's probably pretty straightforward as well. Just unpacking some more stuff for him. I am temporarily going to put plates, bowls, dishes in general, just on the countertop, and then we can tuck them away in some cabinets or some drawers or something. All right, now that the box is empty, we've got everything out on the countertop. This is definitely an electric kettle, or I think it's supposed to be one, but I'm gonna leave it on the stove because I just think it looks nice up there. And then I'm torn between making this area the coffee bar or this area. I don't really want to obstruct the window. Not that they have a great view, it's just the neighbor's house over there. I'm gonna clear out this spot. I'm gonna put all these coffee mugs up here in this cabinet. Since it's got that glass front, I think it'll look pretty solid. I'm having to just crouch up here on the dang countertop because I can't get into this thing otherwise. There we go. Okay, that's decent. It is decent. Let's move these now. This is like a proper espresso machine, actually. Okay, now for the bowls, though. Also, these look kind of weird over here. Maybe let's put those this way. And the little one just in front. Perfect. All right, now for the bowls and stuff. I guess up here? No, let's put them in the glass ones again. Hopefully this is gonna close. Okay, that one's good. This one? Perfect. Mint, dude. We've done it. Okay, anything else? Yes, actually quite a bit. We have to sell the door. Oh, they're going for more of a, well, I meant to get the cell tool out. They're going for a more open kitchen living room setup. That's my guess anyways. Oh yeah, that is considerably better already. Okay, so there was this backsplash, I think, just in the kitchen. That's gonna go right here. Kind of an interesting color choice as well, but it works. You know, they got the blue espresso machine, they've got the yellow bowls, red plates, but we won't talk about that. You can't see them. Now, where is the wood supposed to go? And where's the wallpaper supposed to go? It's the same outline. Maybe, does it say in here somewhere? Negative. No, it does not. Okay, so I'm thinking this, since it's floor to ceiling, maybe that's supposed to be all wood. Let's try it, we'll see what we think. If we hate it, we can swap it out for something else. And that something else is going to be zebra. Not zebra print, literal zebras, the animal. Well, that is something. That is something, ain't it? I don't really know if we went about that the right way. Maybe these areas where there's now a big wood wall, maybe that was supposed to be the zebra wallpaper and everywhere else was supposed to be wood. Either way, they'll probably love it. I also think it's kind of hilarious how our mom was like, you know what kind of colors I like and whatnot, yet she still provided us with a color palette right here. Speaking of colors, actually, we need to paint both a blue and... is that orange? Really, we're going orangey in here. Okay, tell me where. I'll make it happen. Is this specifically for the orangey? It's either or. Let's... oh, shoot. Hang on, let's reference the color palette. There is an orangey in there. Since those walls are already blue, it would make sense for us to do blue over here. But I'm not gonna. I can't do it, dude. We're going orangey. I mean, they obviously appreciate a very bright color palette. So I think that works. I think that totally works. Okay, now that we're done with the wallpaper and the wood and the paint and stuff, I think we're ready for furnishings. This is gonna be both a dining room and a living room, judging by the couch. Oh, we have this here. No, that's the loft area. Never mind, that's for the loft upstairs. So we're on our own for this one. All we have to do now is just unbox these two boxes and get everything put away where it needs to go. So she likes zebras. Of course I knew that, obviously. I'm gonna try to place that right there. This layout doesn't really work for me. I don't love it. Also, where am I going to put these paintings and stuff? Maybe here. There's some orangey in it. I think that kind of works. Maybe up a little bit higher. Right about there. Seems decent. There's another. Of course, there is another. How about here, then? Right smack dab in the middle of that wall. That looks solid. Where is this? Okay, right here. This one's a little bit smaller. You know what? We can make this work. No sweat. No sweat. And that's the big box done. Gone through. Now it's just this small one. Wait, aren't we supposed to be able to ignite these now? That's huge. This is part of the spring update. You can now light candles. You can also, I'm pretty sure, light fireplaces. You can't light a house on fire yet. Maybe there's an arson update coming soon. We don't know. No, but the arson jokes aside, I actually really do like just a simple thing like that. The ability to light a candle on fire. That's kind of cool. The candle's not actually gonna like slowly get smaller and the wax isn't gonna melt and go everywhere and make a massive mess. So it's not realistic in that regard, but you can light them up now. We got $15,000 left in the budget still. And I think this is gonna be our last little area. Do we actually have to do anything in this closet? No. A whole lot of nothing. Maybe we'll have to put some stuff away in there. Oh, this is the area where they sort of helped us out with this little schematic. We do have to paint first. We have yellow or blue. Probably yellow, right? Because there's a lot of blue already. I'm going to start with these two chairs. Really? That's the style you... Okay. Okay. I really want to try to get these plants correct. So I think this one is maybe this guy. And I think this one is the other. But first, we gotta start with the planter boxes. Or the plant pots. I'm gonna put that one right there. Hopefully we have a little bit more space from the wall so it doesn't completely clip through and look terrible. And then this guy is gonna go right here. So again, this one, I'm pretty sure needs to go in this spot. We'll see. Yeah, that looks decent. I think I actually want to like rotate it around a little bit more though and move it more to the right. It doesn't have to be centered on the planter box pot thing, but I want it centered in between the two chairs. So that looks good to me. Let's grab this next one. Oh yeah, see, this is a little bit smaller. That one we can center up in that pot. Entertainment center is going right there. Then they got a nice little TV. Oh, it's got to be offset a little bit because of that roof. There we go. That seems good as long as it's not touching. That's fine by me. And then this guy needs to go in between the two chairs. I do kind of like it at a slight angle like that. Looks like that's how it actually is in the photo as well, or in their drawing. And then we're still missing another plant. I don't see it here. The snake plant, I mean. Maybe. It's probably... I keep hitting my head on the dang ceiling. It's probably too tall for this area, but let me try it. No, actually, that could work. That could work. I'm okay with that. And this shelf also isn't pictured, but that would probably go over here somewhere. And last but not least... A very funky couch. A very funky couch. This is good. You know what? This really looks pretty good. The only thing that I don't care for is this insane color configuration pattern too that's on the couch and these two chairs. Like even this. Whatever the heck this thing is supposed to be. I'm fine with this. But I just don't like, I don't like that. I don't like that. I think it looks bad. Now on to the final room. Oh, this must be our room. Or I guess just their guest bedroom, but we would likely be the only person using it. Are they giving us the choice between these two? Let's go with this one. Let's try this. Just two walls? Easy. Say less. Consider it done already. As for furnishings, we're gonna start with the largest object in the room. I'm so glad that I went with that wallpaper. Because that works perfectly. Oh, there's a desk as well. Okay, we're gonna have to get a little creative. I think I'm actually gonna put this up against that wall like that. Now we'll have plenty of space over here. Get this rotated around right for our nice desk. We've also got a green desk chair. Not something that I would have picked out, but if that's what mom wants to hook us up with, that's cool. That is A-okay. And, oh, that's a pretty good sized dresser, ain't it? Okay, I'm gonna put that right there, and then let's just slide the desk on over. I don't want it right... Oh, I gotta move the chair first. I don't want it right up alongside that wall, though. Maybe just scoot it out a tad. There we are. And then same thing with this. It's not looking too bad in here, if I'm being honest. There's three stars, baby! I gotta pull that away from the wall just a tad. And then the clock... Clock I'm gonna center on the desk. We're gonna put that right there. And then we've got these shelves. Not a lot of space. Not a lot of wall space in here. But we will try to make it work. Okay. I think I'm happy with this. I definitely did care a little bit more about the guest bedroom, since we are most likely going to be the ones staying in this room. But the rest of the house is just... It's a bit too much, I think, even for me. But mom and dad are going to love it. I just know it. Let's finish the job. An easy 29, a cool $29,000 for completion. Nothing to it. Now I'm curious. Earn your first million? Have we actually earned a million in total? I guess that means we've spent almost half of a million, since we only have half a million left. But I'm curious to see now if there's anything else. Anything at all? Okay, I guess not. We do also have these two other areas that aren't outlined. This one here, which looks like a library or something like that. So it is possible that someday we might see some DLC for House Flipper 2. I don't know that for sure, but it's a possibility. I was really trying to be as chatty as I possibly could be throughout that job, but I feel like this episode's gonna be pretty short at this point, so let's tackle some assembly to finish out the day. This first one is gonna be a cabinet, the base cabinet. Hopefully it's not gonna be super challenging. Okay, we've got a couple of pieces right there. It looks like we're gonna be mounting it to the wall, which is accurate. Most cabinets or most cupboards are mounted to the wall. Okay, we've got hinges over here. We're gonna have to put in some little like zert looking things probably. Okay, well, which box do we start with? Probably this one over here, huh? I gotta pick up the pace. I gotta pick up the pace, dude. We're already a minute in. Okay, I can't do anything else with that now. Let's try this box. Let's try this station over here. Maybe we'll be able to keep going. Okay, what the heck is that? Oh, we can scroll through here. Nice. Okay, we need one of those. One of those. Two little dowels. Easy. We just gotta tap it in. Oh, that's not the dowel. Just tap it in. And then these. Looks like we're screwing those in. I'm kind of under the impression that all of these, like, assembly jobs or tasks, whatever you want to call them, I think they're designed intentionally so that you have to do them a second time. Like, you're never going to get a perfect run the first try. Do I just need to screw this in? What's going on, dude? I'm so lost here. Why are there so many different types of screws? It's like, it's unnecessarily confusing. Maybe it's very straightforward and I'm just not the sharpest tool in the shed. The brightest crayon in the box. But I'm trying. Yeah, you know what I've decided? Regardless of how well or how bad we do on this, I don't think I care enough to try it again ever. I think we're just gonna take the score that we get and we're gonna move on to the next one. This one, very challenging. I think we have reached the more challenging, the more difficult assembly items. This one's just got a ton of moving parts, dude. Okay, this shelf goes right there. Perfect. Now I think last but not least, we just have that. Can we pick it up? Okay, done. We got a 4% discount. That's pretty good. We did finish in time, but the hammer is a bit tricky. I kind of have it figured out now a little bit better, but let's move on to the next thing, which is a hanging cabinet. Pretty much the same thing we just did, but this one goes on the wall instead. I'm going to take what I learned previously and try to use that to my benefit, if at all possible. Do we not have to do anything with that box? All right, let's start the clock. Here goes nothing. First step, drill some holes. Nothing difficult about that. Okay, this is actually already so much easier than the base cover. What are these, nails? Oh no. Oh no, the hammer was my downfall last time. All right, it's suddenly not looking so great for us. I'll do my best. The hammer just, dude, it floats around so much, but you can usually get them in with just one swing. There we go. Okay. Yeah, we're all right. Everything's great. For some unknown reason, they wanted me to do the handles for the cabinet before putting the shelf in there. Wait, is that not it? Is that really not it? Do we have to do this twice? No. Okay, thank God. The other one is already partially assembled. I figured there was going to be something with this box that we had to do. Screws, please. just work. First try. There we go. Okay, we've got to tighten four screws, two on each little bracket. These brackets are actually really nice. I wish my own kitchen cabinets had a nice, convenient bracket like this. Mine are just friggin' bolted to the wall, dude. Super sketchy. Okay, and then one more shelf that's going to be right here. Done. I can't leave without closing the cabinets, though. We did pretty good. A 4% discount. Even if we get 2 stars or 3 stars, it doesn't matter. Apparently, it's still 4%. What else we got, dude? I'm ready. Nightstand, that's probably going to suck. Let's go with the bathtub. Surely plumbing's going to be easier than just general assembly, right? Maybe not. We'll find out. Start the dang timer, dude. I have no clue what these are. Oh, they're the feet for the tub. I get it now. Side note, I hate this little menu down here, dude. You can scroll for forever and your thing won't pull up. Still scrolling. Nope, saw it there for a second. There it is. That's what we needed. Ain't no way somebody can do this in under 3 minutes. No shot. I mean, I feel like I was going pretty fast, but okay. Now, what do I do now? I gotta move the camera. This is exactly why there is no possible way you'd be able to do this in under 3 minutes. Having to do this? Probably a 4% discount again, though. Not too shabby. Okay, one more. I think we got one more in here. Let's see what we got. Never mind, we've got a couple more now. Let's do the nightstand and we'll call it a day. How hard could this be, right? Start the timer. Let's get going. Oh my God, please just... And it was just okay. I really just don't quite understand why they think we need to stick our whole dang head inside of this tiny little nightstand to get all these bolts and screws and stuff tightened up. It don't make no sense whatsoever. But I think we're almost done. And honestly, we're making decent time. I don't remember what our time limit was, but now we've got to pan all the way over to the other side of the nightstand just to tighten up three more screws. Oh, and another thing. Yeah, we're probably going to have to assemble a drawer after this as well. We got it. We can do this. It's almost over. It is almost over. I think the last thing that we have to do is just get this little drawer pull fastened together. That should be it. Once again, they're making us stick our entire face in just this little drawer. We didn't do well? What do you mean? How's that even possible, dude? We finished the assembly, and that's good enough for me. How many more we got? Okay, just the radiator and the shower. Yeah, just remind me to never do those again. Oh, those are moderate difficulty. So there could be more challenging ones than those even. Nice. I guess we have that to look forward to. Well, I do think that's probably where we're going to wind things down at for today. Don't freak out. Just because we're done with all the jobs doesn't mean the series is over. I think the next big project for us is going to be another full flip. So we have that to look forward to. But once again, if you guys did enjoy, please leave a like, leave a comment. Help support the dream by smashing that subscribe button. And I will see you in the next one. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Peace.